Earlier this month, school started for children and teens across the country. And we know that some of these students walked into classrooms where they are participating in robust literacy instruction. They are writing, talking, and reading about the big ideas and problems they're studying. These environments will support them to develop and keep pace with what it means to be literate in this 21st century, a time like no other when higher level literacy skills are a prerequisite to adult success. But we also know that many of these students, not just those growing up in poverty, weren't so lucky. They entered less rigorous settings, sometimes not for the first time. For them and for society, the costs of these insufficient literacy learning opportunities, day after day and year after year, are very high. Making good, then, on the promise of our education system means shrinking these vast differences in quality. So how is it that we go about this work? Well, appropriately, as a field, we often turn to standards and curricula, to what the latest brain science is telling us about program design. We embrace new technologies. We try to find time for a longer school day. And there's yet another way in, an uncultivated, unattended to lever for change that I want to talk about today. And that is teacher talk. Did you take the... My pal, Karen. Teacher talk. The words that educators use, whether they're teaching a lesson, having a discussion with students, or even recounting the weekend, it's the consistent voice in our classrooms. And the daily talk that students are exposed to is essential for developing their minds. It's a key ingredient for building up their knowledge of the world, their understanding of concepts and ideas. But why talk about talk when, as a developmental psychologist, my biggest concern is literacy rates? Well, we've known for a long time that conceptual knowledge is the cornerstone of reading success, and that developing conceptual knowledge depends in large part upon the talk that children participate in and are exposed to every day. But as a sophisticated science to inform educational improvement, this relationship between talk and reading is really only just beginning to take shape. And in many ways, I myself only happened upon this notion of teacher talk when I was working on improving middle school literacy rates. We were carrying out a randomized controlled trial of a literacy curriculum in sixth grade English language arts classrooms in a large urban district. And the primary question we had, of course, was, would this curriculum have an impact on students' reading achievement? But when we began to look at what influenced student scores across both the treatment and the control classrooms, we turned to teacher talk. And the data were truly surprising. Through painstaking analysis of hundreds of hours of videotape instruction across the year, we found that sixth graders in this very same district were exposed to very different language environments. For example, in the control condition where we hadn't altered anything and it was just business as usual that we were observing, there was enormous variation in the amount and quality of teacher talk. Based on our data across that 1 year, we found that in the span of a 20-minute instructional event, the typical teacher uses about 60 complex words. But the teacher next door might be using as few as 20, and the teacher down the hall might be using as many as 106. Complex words are central to understanding text, and they aren't ones that we tend to use in the everyday. And this complex word use mattered greatly for students' language and reading growth across the year. The effects were actually larger than much of what we achieved through the reading interventions we have going today. In fact, we found that if the typical teacher using those 60 complex words in a 20-minute span consistently increased those by what we might call one standard deviation, or used 20 more words during that time, we would see almost a year's worth of growth, extra growth in reading in that classroom across the year. What I want to be clear about is the amount of talk didn't seem to matter for students' literacy development. It was simply the type of talk that did. So today's science of talk tells us then that, in fact, it's not about how much talk children and youth hear that influences their reading development, but the substance, the matter of that talk. This is actually in stark contrast to what we used to think, that it was all about how many words parents used with young children. Now we know that this is about educators too, and educators of adolescents no less, which is a good thing, I think, because whether parents of teens are using complex words or not, we can't be so sure that teens are listening. And there is still so much more to learn about this. These findings open up key questions that we have. So remember, the students studied were with these teachers for just one class period a day, about 300 hours total across that year. What might happen if students were enrolled in the highest quality language learning environments from the earliest years right through their public education? In other words, for their 20,000 hours of schooling, how many extra years' growth might accumulate? And what would this mean for students, for all of us in this room, for society? So we dug deeper to better understand the nature of teacher talk with an eye towards implications for educational reform. Going back to the data from our randomized controlled trial, first, we found that variation in this talk could not be explained by teachers' years of experience, advanced degrees, credentials, or even the characteristics of the students in their classrooms. Second, we found that for those teachers using the curriculum, one built around topics and problems that beg the use of complex words, while the intent, our intent, was not to change teachers' speech per se, it did just that. By the end of the year, these teachers were using many more complex words than they were before. And the more teachers' talk shifted, the more their students' vocabulary and reading scores went up. So what happened here? Well, in brief, we tuned them in to the kind of talk that matters for reading. And so if the words and sentences the teachers use play a role in their students' reading development, potentially a bigger role than the implementation of many often expensive curricula and other traditional reforms, where do we go next? We need to continue to investigate classroom talk and how we can shape it. Today's technologies make it more feasible to capture and investigate this talk than even for us a couple of years ago. And over time, we might even connect this to the latest neuroscience research that asks questions about the learning opportunities needed to fuel adolescents' development. And while there's much left to find out, as I stand here today, I would, of course, also argue that a big step forward for advancing literacy rates means cultivating an educational system that recognizes the full implications of and promotes the matter of talk. Thank you.